Hello everyone and welcome to Aviation Made Easy. Today I'll be going over holdings at a DME fix. I'll do my very best to keep this video as short as possible, so bear with me. We will begin with some examples and later on we'll do some exercises. Now, due to high volume of traffic, bad weather, ATC controllers can normally anticipate this delay and they were going to issue a clearance limit, and this is where the pilot usually or get issued a holding clearance at least 5 minutes before the ETA at the clearance limit or fixed. Now, if the holding pattern in the best case scenario that is assigned by ATC is depicted on the aeronautical chart, also known as published, it's going to be very easy for the pilot to identify it, enter it, hold, and expect further clearance. Now, there could be times due to high volume of traffic again that ATC may issue you an unpublished hold. This is when they advise you if you're ready to copy holding instructions, and it's kind of a challenge really if you don't practice it on a regular basis. Now, there's many experienced pilots that can easily mess these holds, so be ready to have a sheet of paper or something to write down these instructions. Now, holds can come in different formats. They can come with different nav aids, and well, the most typical one today is the GPS waypoint. This is widely used in today's aviation. You could also be instructed to hold at a intersection, a VOR, or even an NDB, but to be completely honest, it's not used as much as the past, but you never know. Always expect the worst. But for today's class, we will primarily focus on DME fix, not only within a nav aid, but they're also going to issue a particular distance. But don't worry, we're going to go step by step. We're going to cover all the main components, and hopefully by the end of this video, everything will make sense. Now, when ATC advises you if you're ready to copy down the holding instructions, make sure you grab a piece of paper, an iPad, or something to write down the set of information, because it could be a bit lengthy and you won't remember off by heart if you just try to do it that way. And the cool thing about these instructions, if you think about it, they are given in a standard format, so you'll know basically what to expect, and it just takes practice to get very proficient at it. Now, the very first thing they're gonna give you are the cardinal directions of the holding. Now, these are in terms of the 8 cardinal compass points. And as you can see on this image, it's going to be exactly the same. It could be either north, northeast, east, southeast, south, southwest, west, or northwest. So you're going to be holding with reference to one of these directions. Now, the next thing they're going to give you is the fix to hold. What we already kind of spoke about, this could be a GPS waypoint or whatever. Then they're gonna specify the direction of the hold. This could be given in a radio, a course, bearing, airway, or route. And in length in miles. It's not always applicable, but for today's lesson, we'll practice some of these examples. It doesn't necessarily have to be this way. It all depends on the set of circumstances. And another important factor they're going to give you is if they want you to do right turns or left turns. Remember, right turns are standard and left turns are non-standard. An easy way you can remember this is when you do your regular traffic pattern work, it's always going to be left that's standard. But when it comes to instrument flying, a holding pattern is going to be to the right. So that's a way that I used to remember. And lastly, they're going to give you an expected further clearance time. In case you lose communication, you'll know when to exit the hold and proceed with your approach. Alright guys, now let's look at an example. Suppose ATC gives you the following holding instructions. November 123, hold east on the 15 DME on the 270 radio of the ABC VOR, 5 minute left, expect further clearance at 2030 Zulu. Now, at first, this could be slightly overwhelming. There's a whole bunch of information that has been thrown out at you. But guys, the trick to this is not to write down everything word by word. No, just highlight the main points. They told us to hold east on the 15 DME the 270 radio, AVC VOR, 5-minute legs, expect further clearance at 2030 Zulu. How would I write this down? I wouldn't even put east. I'll just put the letter E, 15D for DME or distance. The 270 radio, I wouldn't put radio, I'll just put an R next to it, and the ABC VOR. Now this is important because there could be multiple VORs within the vicinity. 5-minute legs. Expect further clearance at 2030 Zulu. Now notice how they didn't specify if it's gonna be a left turn or right turn. When they don't specify, it's gonna be a standard to the right. When they do specify, they're just gonna put left turns. Okay, so what's the next thing I do? I normally just draw a point or draw my hold. I don't normally put the cardinal compass points, but for the purpose of this video, I will. So we can put north, east, south, and west. Now, the next thing that I normally do is just draw out my cardinal directional point. So just draw a straight line towards the east because that's where they told us to hold, hold east. Now we want to verify which turn. Is it going to be right or left? In this case, it's going to be right. So just draw your hold to the right. Now that you have this out of the way, you want to find out where the VOR is referenced to this diagram. They did say, they did specify the 270 radio. Remember guys, radials are always from the station outwards. So it'll make perfect sense if the station's here and the radio 270 will look like this. They told us to hold on the 15 DME, 5-minute legs. So when we turn inbound, we're supposed to be around the 10 DME. Obviously, expect further clearance at 2030 Zulu. Now you just gotta know where, look at your instruments and find out where you are in reference to the station. Now, suppose this is your airplane and you're flying towards the west. It will make perfect sense just to enter on a direct procedure. Now, what happens if you're coming from this side? Well, you have to find out which type of entry it's going to be. You can obviously tell this is, it could either be a teardrop entry or just do a parallel entry and get yourself in the hold and expect further clearance. Now, let's look at, I'll give you guys a exercise, have a go, pause the video, and then we will verify if we got it right or not. All right, guys, now it's time for you to have a go at this exercise. You can pause the video, do your working out, and see if you get it correct. Now, what's the first thing we do? We write down the instructions. In this case, we will be holding west on the 20 DME fix, on the 090 radio of the ABC VOR, 5-mile leg, EFC 1800 Zulu, and standard turns once again to the right. What's the next step? Just draw a little dot on your piece of paper, just like that. North, east, south, and west. Now, we know we will be holding to the west, so just draw a straight line. Is it gonna be a left or right turn? It's gonna be a right turn again. Draw out your hold, and now we just wanna verify where the station is. Since they said the 090 radio, it'll make perfect sense if the station would be around here, and we just draw out the radio. 090 radio. It's gonna be a 20 DME leg. I mean, sorry, 5-minute leg, so we should expect to do our inbound turn around here. And there you have it. That's pretty straightforward. If you just practice these instructions, you're gonna get a hang of it. Now let's do one more. All right, guys, once again, have a go. Pause the video if you need to. And the instructions goes as follows. Hold northwest on the 30 DME fix, 130 radio, 123 VOR, 10-mile leg, left turns expect for the clearance at 1700 Zulu. So let's draw out our hold. We'll put a dot north, east, south, west. Now notice this time they want us to hold northwest. So draw a line towards the northwest. Is it a right or left turn? This time is actually going to be to the left. And then we have to draw the radial. So if the radial is 130, it'll make sense that the station should be over here, because the 130 radial should be something like this. We'll draw out our 30 DME. 10 mile leg, so we should draw the 220 DME here. And there you have it. That's how the holding procedure will look like. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe for more. Until next time.